Hello. It's nearly the end of March now, and what you can start sowing in March are peas. Now, whether you want to grow sugar snaps, normal peas, or mange too, you can start sowing them and growing them in March. Now, what I would suggest you do is that you don't sow all your seeds together. Peas are best sown. I'm going to class all of them as peas because they are. They're always best sown successionally, which means that you sow some at the beginning of 1 month, some at the in 1 month, some 4 weeks later in the next month, and then some the following month, and so on and so forth. And you can go through all the way through until about June, July time, depending on the variety you have. Now, I'm growing snap peas, sugar snap peas, because I like those and I like them really fresh. Now, sugar snaps and mange too do not freeze at all. They come out very mushy and disgusting. So you do need to pick and eat. So if you don't want to be completely and utterly overrun with them, then I would suggest that you plant them successionally. Now, the variety I have here are called Nairobi. There we are. I've grown these before and they've grown really, really well. Usually I tend to start them off in the greenhouse, especially in March and April, and then I will transplant them outside when they're just a little bit bigger. If we get to sort of May and June, I tend to sow directly outside. I tend to find that March and April could be just a little bit cold for them to germinate, and I find that the germination rate is much higher if I start them off in the greenhouse and then move them outside. Now, they don't like their roots being disturbed much, so it's always best if you can sow your peas in a pot, and then you can just very carefully move them out of the pot and then straight into the ground. So let me show you how I'm going to sow my peas, my sugar snap peas, into pots. So I've got one of my little square pots here. What I'm going to do is I'm just going to fill it right to the top and overflowing just with normal multi-purpose compost. Give it a tap down so that it will sort of all the bits, any holes that there are in the bottom, will start to get filled up. And then I would just give it a gentle pat down. Now, what I'm going to do is I'm going to sow 4 seeds per pot. I know that seems quite a lot, but you want at least 2 or 3 to come up. The germination rate is usually pretty good for peas, but I'd rather have too many than not enough. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to use my finger and I'm just going to make a hole about 1 inch deep into the compost, just like that. Okay, maybe do it down, maybe just over 1 inch, do it down to this big knuckle here. There we go. And all I'm going to do is I'm just going to drop 1, 2, 3, 4 seeds in that hole. I don't see the point of putting them in each corner or north, south, west and east if you have a circular pot, because when you sow them in the ground, you will put a little clump of them together and they'll be quite happy there. So all I'm going to do now is I will just fill up that little hole, level it off, and that's one done. So I can fit 15 of these in one of my big trays. So I will do an entire tray, and then when I've done that, then I will come back to you. Well, there are my 15 pots in my tray. So say I've got 4 seeds in each one. So hopefully about 75 to 80% of those should germinate. Obviously, it depends how old your seeds are. The older your seeds get, then the germination rate does decrease really quite quickly. So make sure you label them correctly, and then you know whether they're sugar snaps, whether they're mange too, or whether you've got to let them swell up and harvest the peas. Now, all I'm going to do with these is I'm going to give them a really good water. Make sure you use tap water to start with. Once they start to germinate and they're about 1.5 to 2 inches tall, then you can use water from a water butt. But just the initial bit of watering whilst they're starting to germinate needs to be water straight from the tap. So hopefully in about 2 weeks, 3 weeks, they should start popping through the surface. And then once I put these outside, obviously I will show you that, but once I pop these outside, which should hopefully be in about a month's time maybe, then I will start the next lot off. So by the time these ones are finished, then the next lot will be ready. So I love fresh peas. Fresh peas taste absolutely fabulous. Well, I hope you are growing some form of pea this year. They really are well worth trying. Sugar snaps, you can let get a little bit fatter than mange two. Mange two, you have about 2 days where they are absolutely perfect and then they go over. And then they get stringy and they taste horrible. Whereas sugar snap peas, actually, you've got about 4 days where they're perfect, and then they just go too far, and again they go stringy. But the if you let them get, if you have peas, and you've got quite a long time before they will spoil. So, but I do like sugar snaps. I think they're lovely. Anyway, I will keep you updated on their progress, and I hope you found that useful, and I look forward to seeing you soon. Bye-bye.